That is Ted Mendez, one of the country's most influential military-grade money men. This must be connected to Kronstadt.
Bill, it's Ted here. Just returning your call before heading over to the expo building to meet Knox for the new combat android presentation.
No,
not yet. I'm letting him stew. The guy's a genius, and you know what they're like. That's what you're lacking in this whole respect for other people. Last time I tried to have a meeting with him, he had me sitting in a room for 4 hours before canceling. I'll head up my feet later. All right, I'll call you after the presentation. Speak then.
Ted Mendez, a defense funding consultant with the U.S. military, is scheduled for a private demonstration of a new Kronstadt robotics project. Sounds like a way to get up close and personal with Robert Knox, 47.
Demonstration is scheduled to take place on the upper floors. Please feel free to use the stairs right over there.
Report anything suspicious to us, okay?
Collecting pictures of celebrity entrepreneurs now, 47? What are you thinking?
Them to safety or patching them up then and there,
android pilots delivering payloads deep inside enemy territory with uncanny precision and minimal collateral damage. All right, Mendez, it's very straightforward. Let me show you. I just pick any of the pictures on the desk, then I use the scanner to upload the biometric data, and Palace will do the rest.
Target acquired. Don't get me.
Obviously, the final system won't rely on you manually feeding it biometric data. This is still a prototype. This is a pivotal moment in modern conflict solution, Ted.
Palace is entirely foolproof. All you need is to pick a photo from the table and scan it. Just like I showed you, it's perfectly safe. Go ahead. Make my day.
Knocks down. Now for the heir to the Constant Empire.
Ready to meet up with Sierra Knox over at the hotel. Yeah, after the race. I just got to pick up the documents from my van, but I had to knock out a guy and steal his flamingo outfit. Now I can't find my car keys. Yeah, I know it's dumb. I think I lost them in the scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there. If I don't get them, I've got no evidence. Bye-bye money. I don't know. I need to figure something out. Talk soon.
A disgruntled Kronstadt employee has acquired some dirt on Sierra Knox and intends on blackmailing her. Disguised as one of the racing mascots, he plans to meet Sierra by the old motel. Well, I always did feel that pink was your color, 47.
Hey, can you do me a favor? Go check if my keys are over there.
He stole my mascot outfit. Who would do that?
Hey, yo, did you find some keys over there? Oh man, you're a real lifesaver, thank you.
Thank you. Don't come.
The race is entering its final lap, 47.
Cooper gave me some sort of vitamin hydration boost, normally reserved for the drivers. Fixed me right up.
What?
No.
The race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track any time now. 8:47. The race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track any time now.
Sorry.
Brings out your eyes. Miss Knox informed me you'd be here. She asked to make sure you brought the documents. So, did you bring the documents?
I have the papers right here.
Excellent. Come on in. Have a seat or something. I'll let Miss Knox know you're here.
So far, so good, 47. Now, let's see where this meeting is headed.
There's a guy here wearing a mascot outfit. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't give a damn about it. I'll let him know you're hungry.
Hey, Flamingo guy. Miss Knox is on her way. Have a seat somewhere. She'll be here as soon as she can.
So, it's a great outfit. Thinking it must get pretty warm in there, though.
It's insulated.
Huh. Imagine that. Guess it would have to be if you're supposed to wear it for hours and hours every day. Do you, you know, get to use it at home? For parties and things like that, I mean.
No.
Right. I have a friend who's into that sort of thing. Cosplay, assuming imaginary identities. He says it's very liberating. Takes him out of the stress of everyday life and work, you know?
Not really.
Yeah, I guess it's different when you do it for a living. How's the pay?
Sufficient.
Nice. Okay, good talk.
So, Mr. I never did catch your name.
Names are for friends.
Very well. Straight to the point in all business. Walk with me.
Where are we going?
Don't worry. What am I gonna do? Kill you in broad daylight. I just want a bit of privacy here. Not about to do sensitive business like this in front of an audience.
Good idea.
So just to get this straight, you claimed in your email to have somehow found internal reports that show Kronstadt's involvement in the Tungan Valley Massacre.
Sounds about right.
Let's be clear. You and I are having this meeting because my father doesn't need to know about this. It's just another undesired distraction. I don't care if the information is true or false. I don't care if it mentions moving money from the Nexus Project into Tungan Valley Damage Control, as you claimed in your correspondence. I do care about protecting my father, which is why you and I are now here.
I see.
Leave me alone for a few minutes, guys.
Sure thing, Miss Knox. If you need us, just call. We're right around the corner.
So here's the deal. You hand over the documents and leave, and that's the end of it. And you will do that now. So here are the two possible outcomes of this meeting. One, you will leave...
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
Offer them some.
You ought to know.
I Lei speaks the enemy's language. We need them.
And once we don't?
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Fact remains, we are shadowboxing. We need to know who we are up against.
I was getting to that. His name is Lucas Gray, the late Mr. Cobb's head of security. Cobb was ground zero, first of our operatives to die. It had to be one of his staff, someone with military training and access to the plane.
Grasping at straws.
Gray is a mercenary, a veteran of every backwater tragedy you've ever ignored on the 5 o'clock news. Chechnya, Sierra Leone, the list goes on, but before 89, nothing. No records of any kind.
Oh, come on. CIA, KGB, plenty of spies went dark.
After the curtain was lifted, I cast a very wide net. Lucas Gray simply does not exist.
If you're all quite done wetting yourselves with excitement, I couldn't give two shits where he came from. I only want to know one thing.
How does he know about us?
I swear to God, this hearts and flowers crap will get us both killed. Can't you see? Your so-called friend is working for them now. He's not the man you knew.
Even if he doesn't realize it. Like it or not, 47 is our last and only lead on the partners. He needs to remember.
He's coming for us. And unlike you, he won't hesitate.
Let's get inside. Rico, I need a favor.